Hello YouTube, Lorenzo here. Second battle for Hit Curl tournament. We are playing Solucids. I picked up the faction. Let's check out the army just before the beginning of the battle. So this is my opponent, Inquisitor of Agartha. That's the second battle that we are doing. I won the first one. We were playing Athens, and I was very lucky to actually win this game. I was not at ease with Athens. I'm not playing this faction usually. I picked up Seleucids this one because I know this this faction, and I know the units, and I liked it. I like this faction actually, quite diversified and good, strong, sturdy units. Good choice of cav, and which I like. So there was also a choice of elephant and chariot. So in this time, I actually decided not to take a chariot, but to take an elephant, a war elephant. I have four pikes, and I opted for lead attack spikes, not the bronze shield one. So lower units. I have two light peltast to support actually this front line. I have on the side two bronze shield, silver shield, sorry, swordmen, and I have another sword here on the side. I have four calves plus my gen. I like this combination. The idea is, as usual, that I'm actually going to focus on one side. So I notice here you have an elephant. I need to be careful here. He has actually archers, so this is going to be quite deadly for my elephants, because he may try to run in amok with our flamed arrow, which I cannot. You know, I don't have the range actually to do that. So my intention is to block eventually the elephant with my cav. And actually two sides. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go this way, try to flank him this way, maybe, you know, in you know, as a way he doesn't really maybe understand my maneuver, and that he stays actually, he offers his flank to me, maybe by trying to distract with the cav, and trying to actually making him look somewhere else rather than, you know, going like that, then moving, and then so that I can actually move on the side. So let's see actually the battle and comment the army while the units are moving up. So the army of my opponent is a one made of actually six royal peltasts, so heavy swords. Not like my choice, really. I would say rush, because he has only two support units. These are the actually, he has one archer and one javelin. I didn't notice that during the battle. And he has, like me, he has four cav, actually one cav less, because his gen is part of that, which is an advantage for me. And he has also made the choice of having one war elephant, which are really deadly beasts and animals. Although I may have an advantage because war elephants, they are not still not good in front of pikes, I think, when pikes are you know, enabled information basically. So that's what I was trying to indicate. I'm trying to flank, so maybe not too obviously. He is actually maybe making a mistake, because you see his position is not good. I will soon be in formation like that when his units are already some of these units are well behind. I'm already rushing my peltast to hit the first of his units. I think I'm no, I will not try to hit his gen, but I'm very careful, you know, not to be charged. Here I see that he wants, you know, maybe to engage. I don't want that, because my two units are, you know, these are two cataphracts, so heavy like that. He has four cataphracts actually, when I have only two. So I don't want my cav without any support. Here I get a good a good shot at this strong unit. He's shooting as my at my gen, so I will move it back. I try to distract and make use here, and I have brought this side, actually my elephant, away from the archer. So now that the units are engaged, I'm going to charge. My elephant is actually behind his line, which is not good. I'm already flanking, you know, two units. This is a pike, so very effective. He's still trying to bother me here. He has indeed now launched his elephant. His elephants are going to shred apart this unit, but which is actually my weakest one. I'm countercharging, maybe not very efficiently, but let's see here. Do I take the charge? It's not really decided. I countercharge the elephant with my general, because I think cav is quite helpful against elephants. I've won here on this side. His units are still very much engaged, but now, you know, I can really flank them. I have this cav that is going to be able to rush towards these units. This one I'm not doing so well because he has his main force, but actually I'm going to win quite significantly this easily this part, and then we're going to free up all my units. You know, I don't have so many losses. We can see that on the bar here. I still have my elephant, and he has lost his missile units. What's going to be really, really, really helpful is that I'm going to send these elephants towards his units, which are already a bit damaged. I'm losing my gen, but these units are holding for somehow. This is a pike indeed. You see his elephants are dead, and look, these units are going to actually be scared quite significantly by the elephants, which are going to make as well some damage, and the game will be over soon. So that was a good game, good tactic. I think I maneuvered my opponent. This was the replay, by the way, which was I think very close to the real battle. We won't see, I think, the stats. I don't know why. Sometimes I saw it once on a replay, this time not. So replays are still a bit bugged, but this was really the what happened during the battle. So unfortunately I cannot show you. I had the live record, but it was much more interesting maybe to share some of the, you know, comments and tactical insights with the over the replay. So hope you enjoyed. And now I'm moving. We are moving to the third battle. This is the best of five. So I won the first two. There is, at least one more to go. So see you then. See you next time. Bye.